Yay! Look, the adorable, cute young baby here.
Baby,
what's up, baby? What's up, baby? Wow. Bless you.
Who's
pulling at my hair? So she can walk by herself?
No.
No.
Okay. She's still unstable to walk
okay.
by herself.
So he's talking about how to rub the sticks to get the sun, I mean to get the fire.
Yes.
So the lady, the young man is going to show us how to make fire.
So
we have fire. So actually, the gentleman is the husband of all the ladies.
No. That's his girlfriend in front, and next to the other guy in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's the old one. She's younger than him. Mm-hmm. I think she is now 59.
Mm-hmm.
But as I before, it just depends what you are using on your body.
Uh-huh.
Because most of the people who is using alcohol,
mm-hmm.
they don't eat. They are mostly consuming alcohol and smoking.
Uh-huh.
So that actually can kill their capacity of fitness.
Uh-huh.
So he was also drinking, but now he's not anymore drinking.
Uh-huh.
So it's hard for you actually get his body back.
Mm-hmm.
Around his arm. That cut was actually done by the people at home. Because
mm-hmm.
You need a cut quite deep so the blood can move out. You can see that cut here. So all these cuts. These cuts actually quite deep inside. It's
mm-hmm.
not the cut which is outside, it's quite deep. So
mm-hmm.
the blood can continue to move out.
Yes.
And then up to Venuk and then.
Wait, sorry.
Just a lot of juice in this.
Boil it and then with a fire. Tastes good.
So it you cough a lot and maybe you're sneezing, you can just come and get some of the leaves. And then just to meet, you just need the juice from the leaves. It helps against coughing. And afterwards, if you maybe go out for hunt, if you want to make the arrow a bit stronger, because here this poison we have here, it's not the poison that we are buying from the shops. It's a poison that they get from the under the trees from a little red worm, which is very poison. So they dig it under the trees and they get it, and they.
And the young man is about.
He is about now 32, roughly plus minus, I think. So.
I got to go.
So if the berries come out, then you can eat from the berries.
Uh-huh.
So, you can harvest it, you can take it back at home,
uh-huh.
and then you can go give it to the ladies to eat.
Uh-huh.
But for us as gentlemen, we use the main stumps to make the bowls,
the
and
bowl.
Also the walking sticks.
Mm-hmm.
On the large, little stick that the old guy had, that's a walking stick, which is coming from these bowls. So the gravia bush is one of the bowls which is quite flexible. And you can bend it any way you want, any type you want, they will just do exactly what you want them to do. So, but again, another thing that what we are doing with the gravia bush is for the ladies which give birth. So most of the ladies, if they're pregnant, they don't know especially which time, which day they'll give birth. So they'll just take each other and go out to go gathering some fruits and vegetables. But if she is now getting that pain, leaves are green, they also use the leaf to make green tea. So they get the leaf, they go cook it, and then the green flavor comes out, and they just add sugar and then they drink. So that's now the brandy bush or the gravia bush that we are using for medicine, for weapons, also for the berries to eat.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the one.
And what's the name of the bush?
This is the gravia bush,
gravia
and this
bush.
Is the camphor bush. So it's
camphor.
Two types of bush that we have. So the camphor bush is for coughing and for sneezing.
Mm-hmm.
The gravia bush is for harvesting for fruits, for weapons, and also for giving birth.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I see. Come here.
But their pain really goes away?
Yes, it really goes away. Yeah, it's just like a painkiller. Small room come